Hey, my phone!
If you've ever went through the Apple App Store, you might have noticed this cool-looking card.
Give it back!
What makes it stand out to me is the way that it scrolls seamlessly and never runs out of items to show. Today, we're gonna replicate it in CSS.
Police! Freeze!
Get down to the ground!
We kick things off by creating our projects directory and initializing it as a Node.js project with npm init-y. Then we add Snowpack to our dev dependencies, which by its own words is a lightning-fast front-end build tool, but we will mainly be using it as a live reload server. For that, we add a start script that just runs Snowpack dev. Then we add an index.html file, a CSS folder which holds our main.css, and a folder for our images. Now we can open up our index.html and add the needed boilerplate. If you have Emmet installed, you can do this by typing an exclamation mark, followed by a tab. Then we reference our main.css file. With that done, we can start work on our component. And this component is going to be a card that will contain a category, a title, and three auto-scrolling containers, which will later contain our icons. Let's take a look at what we've got so far by running npm start. And yeah, there's a lot that we can improve upon. So let's head into our main.css. Now, in a bit, you're gonna see a lot of magic numbers. Don't let that intimidate you. They aren't anything special, just the values I thought made our work come as close to the source material as possible. First off, we can center our page's content. Then we can give our card class a height, width, box shadow, background, and border radius. The values given to our box shadow are the X and Y offset, blur radius, and color. If these parameters confuse you like they did me at first, I recommend just searching for the property name in the Mozilla Web Dev Docs. And as the name implies, you can find almost anything web development related, so be sure to bookmark it. Moving on to our category class. Here we can fix it up by adding some padding, specifying its font size, bolding the text, uppercasing it, and changing its color. Our title is also going to get some padding, a larger font size, and it's also going to get chunky. Next on the line are the icons, and to get those up and running, we first have to copy some images over to our image folder, and reference them as the source attribute to some image tags, nested inside of our autoscroll container. Oh yeah, and they also need an icon class. Then we save, and it looks like going back to our main.css, we can create our icon class, specify its width, height, border radius, and margin. This brings our icons very close to the original, but not quite there. And the thing that's missing is the light gray border around the icons that have a white background. So we add an icon outline class to the icons that need it, declare the class in our CSS, and add the border. That's a lot better. On to the most interesting part, the infinitely auto-scrolling icons. Now, Apple aren't the ones who invented this effect, and there are multiple ways to achieve it, but the simplest one that I found is done like so. We nest our icons inside a div with a class of autoScrollRollTop. We declare both autoScrollRollTop and autoScrollContainer to be flexboxes with flexDirectionRow. Then we simply add an animation to the autoScrollRollTop that translates the entire width of the row to the left, lasts 2 seconds, has a linear acceleration, and repeats infinitely. The last thing we need to do in order to complete this effect is to simply duplicate our autoScrollRollTop div, hide the card's overflow, and voila, we have our automatic infinitely scrolling roll of icons.
But why does it work?
Excellent question, Timmy. Let's go a step back and let me also color the second row blue in order to visualize what's happening a bit better. Did you get it? Well, if not, there are two main things to understand here. The first thing is that both autoscroll rolls have the same translation speed, so the second one follows the first. Because of this, we don't see the white space after the first row leaves the card. It gets covered by the second row. The second thing is that because both row animations start and loop over in unison, we don't see the rows jolt back into their original position after the animation ends. This happens because both rows are identical copies, and the ending position of the second roll looks exactly like the starting position of the first roll. So when both rolls snap back into their initial state, we don't notice anything. Basically doing the equivalent of the ye olde CSS switcheroo. To wrap things up, we just add two more rolls while shuffling some of the icons a bit, and create a new animation for the middle roll, this time starting and ending the animation in a different position in order to create this cool offset. Oh yeah, and we also change the animation duration to something a bit slower. If this looks a little bit too bland to you, we can speed it up a bit, or a lot, change directions, add a fog effect on the edges, basically the sky is the limit. If you found this video interesting or helpful, consider liking it or subscribing to the channel. You can also check out this video on a Discord bot integrated with Spotify, or this one, which covers a simple continuous integration solution with GitHub Actions. Thank you for watching.